It's John Clark, and in this video, we're talking about Google Ads for therapists in private practice and why most therapists fail with this platform. Let's dive in. Okay, so I've helped well over 300 therapists around the country build a private practice and get more clients. And through that experience, I've learned a lot about what works and where most therapists fall short. So I'm going to be running through the main reasons why I see most therapists having failed with Google Ads and then concluding Google Ads doesn't work. Okay, so reason number one is oftentimes they're using the express version of the full Google Ads platform. Now, why does Google offer this express version if it's not as good as the bigger kind of the bigger full version? Well, they offer it because it's a way to just get people started with Google Ads without overwhelming them with all the features that are in the platform. Now, the reality is to be successful with the platform, you don't have to know every single feature of Google Ads, but most therapists, they don't have help with this. And so when they go in and try to do it themselves, they just get totally overwhelmed. When you don't have the help you need, it can be overwhelming. But when you do have the help, it can be extremely powerful in getting new clients whenever you need them. The AdWords Express version, or the Google Ads Express version, I should say, the version is quite limited, and therefore your results are going to be quite limited. So if you've used this version before, or if you're using it now, you've got to switch over to the full platform to really get powerful results. Number two, running ads to their homepage. Now, Google wants to see, they want to take specific search traffic and send it to specific pages, right? So if I'm searching for something as specific as EMDR, you don't want to just send me to the homepage of a practice that does all sorts of things beyond EMDR. When you do that, it means that the consumer has to go through a bunch of unnecessary clicks in order to find the information that they need. So again, if you're going to be running Google Ads, don't run those ads to your homepage. Number three, an unclear or uncompelling message. Now, in order for Google Ads to work, you have to address all these different points of conversion. So if the ads are working well, that means they're guaranteed to get people to your pages. Now it's up to your pages to do the job to get people onto the phone. And from there, once you get people onto the phone, you or your admin or whomever's answering the phone needs to be able to convert. It all comes down to, though, addressing that critical conversion point of having strong, clear, and compelling copy. That means having a message that's really focused on the benefits and outcomes of what you do for your clients. Number four, poor calls to action. So your call to action is the button that sends people to the next step. So to fill out the contact form or pick up the phone now or whatever it is, you need to have strong, clear, and compelling calls to action that repeat over and over again in order to really get the most out of the Google Ads platform. Number five, lack of patience and understanding. There is a testing period using Google Ads, no matter how good you are at it, where you're going to be testing your ads with the market, getting information, making decisions with that information, and then continuing to push forward. If you don't understand this, then you will get frustrated really quickly with Google Ads, and you'll conclude falsely that it doesn't work. The reality is that getting fully booked is simple math, and when you understand that simple math, it's very powerful and it changes the way that you approach your entire practice. Number six, therapists don't know their numbers. So not only do they not know their numbers for Google Ads, but they don't know the rest of the key performance indicators of their business, and in this case, their digital marketing. So in order to make decisions about what's going on in your practice or where your marketing is going wrong, you have to know your numbers. It's as simple as that. Finally, number seven, they fail to convert people once they do get people on the phone. So again, you can have the ads working really well, the landing page is working really well and converting, but once you get people on the phone, you're nervous, you're not sure about your fees, or maybe you're just missing phone calls altogether and you need someone to answer the phone for you. Whatever it is, once you get people on the phone, you have to be able to convert. That's the final conversion point on this, along this process, and you need to be able to do it well and consistently. All right, so there you have it. Those are my seven tips on how to be successful with Google Ads for therapists in private practice, including why most therapists fail with this platform. Hope this video was helpful. Do me a favor, click that subscribe button. Let me know what you think about this video in the comments below. And if I can help you build a fully booked private practice, head to thejohnclark.com right now. That's thejohnclark.com. See you very soon.